Welcome to Diaspora 360, where I will bring you news and views about what's happening in Diaspora. Now, I had just completed elections for the chairmanship position of the Central Association of Nigerians in the UK, otherwise known as CANUC, where Mr. Babatunde Lawyer, yes, where Mr. Babatunde Lawyer emerged as the new chair after a keenly contested battle with the other candidates. Mr. Charles Ajayi Kiran gave a very, very profound and interesting speech about leadership that I felt the whole diaspora community and even the delegates and the elected chair and also his executives need to be reminded about. He's wonderful. Charles Ajayi Kiran is a fantastic MC, compere, consultant. He's a top man. So I want you to watch this video and see the top man, the top MC, the splendid Charles Ajayi Kiran present his case about leadership and the future for CANUC and the direction we should go. Thanks a lot for watching. Thumbs up to you, Mr. Charles. You've done a great job. Go with your vision. Now, there are strict, I'm just going to say for a moment that there are no predetermined factors that makes a great leader. We have seen them tall, short, fat, round, whatever. Some are silent, some are very, very outspoken and dynamic. What is key, of course, is the type of leadership that they are able, if you will, to provide for the people who they want to lead. Number two, you've got to be values-driven. And by values, I mean you've got to get to the point where your values are non-negotiable. When I mean non-negotiable, what is it? No matter what it is, that you will not be bought. Whether it's money, what boundaries have you set for yourself that you will not cross as a leader? Because those will define your values. What do you stand for that is so important to you? That no matter how much they give you, who calls you in the night, or whispers in your ears, you say, I'm sorry, my personal integrity will not allow me to do that. Number three, leaders are not necessarily liked. Get that clear in your mind. If you are looking to be liked, you've lost the plot. Leadership is not about being liked, because you have to make difficult decisions. And making difficult decisions means there are times you're going to have to say no. And you will not be popular for that. If you are looking to be liked, you've lost the plot. Leadership is about admiration. Be admired rather than to be liked. If you are liked, it's an extra bonus. Values driven, understanding your vision, stand on the mighty T word, trust. If you lose trust, all has been lost. If you lose trust, all has been lost. Some of you will know you've called me to vote and I've told you no. Whether you like me or not is totally irrelevant. I've got to stand by my values. I will cheer you on the sidelines, but I will not tell you I'm going to vote for you tomorrow. I won't do it. Okay? So here's what's important. You've got to be trusted. People have got to know they can do business with you because you are consistently consistent. You are consistently consistent. If we are going to change the community, we have to begin with a few of these watchwords that should govern everything we do, and that's how you create outstanding societies. Trust. Then, of course, you've got to understand that you've got to be able to execute. There's no point having all of these wonderful things you cannot execute. Execution, the world is paying top dollar for people who can execute. The deal today is how well can you execute? How well can you deliver? It's about deliverables. It's not about activities, it's about results. So what are the handful of results that you want to achieve during your tenureship? You've got to have that clear in your mind. All right, as part of my legacy, I want to see a few of these things written about me because I have been able to leave these things behind. That is so very, very important. I don't contest that behind the back, pushing people forward. Know your what you've been called to do, okay? So it is very, very important we understand all of these things, and then, of course, if you learn how to truly communicate. Communication does not mean verbal articulation or communication or oratory. Communication means being able to be understood. All right? You send a message, the other person receives it, you send it back, the communication loop is complete. Long as they understand your message. And then, of course, learn how to liaise and learn how to build superior relationships. This is all about relationships. All about relationships. How do even those who don't like you, how do you meet them and agree and have a peaceful coexistence? And this is really what we are talking about. Finally, tenacity. Let me say this to you. All right? As carbon makes steel, the character of a human being and tenacity will build your character. Tenacity means in the face of all opposition, in the face of every challenge you're going to have, you do not give up. You don't give up. You stay with what you know. You stay with what you believe, no matter what anybody says. What anybody says, you do not give up. That is why people will talk about you. That's why they will praise you. This is why they will cheerlead you, because they know you are a person of conviction. We are going to have a brand new chairperson this afternoon who wants to lead this amazing, dynamic community. You're going to need the help of God to be able to make your mark on this. And we are here to support you and see you to the top. God bless all of you.